have like a coin in your pocket or something like that, I'd like y'all to take that out and run this flare. Okay.
Bye, dude.
My name is Cole Warner. Raise your hand if you have scrolled through your Facebook, liked a photo on Instagram, or sent a text message today. So probably all of you. What if I told you that anything online-based, communication-wise, or anything that has to do with satellite-based communication, or anything with satellites, will become impossible in an instant? There are 4,854 satellites in space at this very moment, most of which are communication satellites, but they're all threatened at this very moment. A not-so-known phenomenon to most of y'all called the Kessler Syndrome is brought by NASA scientist Donald K. Kessler, is a phenomenon where there's so much debris in space that the likelihood of collisions occurring increases, thus creating a further cascade of collisions. There's 17 million pieces of debris in space at this very moment. There's only 22,000 being tracked, but most of this debris is fragmented pieces, but it also consists of spacecrafts, mission-related debris, or rocket bodies. But I want y'all to understand the impact of this. Take out the penny or quarter or whatever you have and cut it in half. This is a centimeter of diameter traveling at thousands of miles per hour in space, doing damage to a solid block of steel. Now think about 17 million. But why does this matter? Why should you care about this? Satellites are the basis behind many operation systems, observation systems, navigation systems, weather systems, communication systems, and military systems too. To help you understand the Kessler Syndrome, it was brought attention media-wise in the 2013 film Gravity. I don't know who's all seen it in here, but basically it's Sandra Bullock and George Clooney, and they're trying to survive in a space storm in space. But all the satellites and everything, all the crafts in space are being destroyed. But this is basically the image of what happened to a satellite in a collision. Now, I don't know how much y'all think this is a problem, but this has began to increase throughout the years, and we haven't really done anything about it. But why should you care? How would this even affect you? For all those who just raised your hand, this is already you're already being affected by this. Imagine, when's the last time you've gotten an atlas out on a family road trip? Not very recently. Imagine all the security systems that would fail due to the lack of satellite imagery. Imagine the coastal populations on a coast because they can't be warned that a hurricane is coming. Now, people who track hurricanes and disasters and stuff like that use satellites to detect them. But what happens when a population on a coast is not warned in time and cannot evacuate? A simple natural disaster becomes catastrophic. Now, this doesn't just affect that, but what about the implications in the global economy? What about the companies that base their front on satellite technologies? They would plummet, along with those who use satellites to further implicate the technology. There's no telling the effect on the economy this would have, but I can tell you that it would not be in the right direction. But how are you going to stop this? How is something thousands of miles away, how is the common person supposed to affect that? The answer is money. Now, I know that sounds like a begging for money or something, but I'm not. So don't go empty in your pockets and start donating. But anyways, I'm not asking you to think about spending money, but rather how your money is spent currently. The government is putting funds towards installing new satellites and space missions, but I want y'all to think about how what this will affect in the future as well. Space travel, all that will become impossible in an instant. SpaceX, a privately owned company, has plans to launch a rocket to Mars in 2020. However, this would simply just become impossible and more of a dream rather than reality. But anyway, going back to your money, this is a design craft called it's a space sweeper basically. What it does is it sweeps up all the trash in space. Now, I know it's impossible to get rid of all the trash in space. If you could, you'd try to clean up all the trash on Earth, but it's just impossible. But any step towards this is a step in the right direction.